Hello, I'm Scott Hayden. I'm the head of teaching, learning and digital at Basingstoke College of Technology. And this is Teaching for Tomorrow. I want to help people feel that, like they can learn in a way that makes sense to them in ways beyond just an essay or just a lecture. So I feel like my entire career has been geared towards trying to help people who learn differently have access to learning. I think this is the most exciting time in the history of education. I really do. I was observing a lesson and helping a teacher in a maths lesson, and a student with autism was supported by one of our teaching assistants. I was watching the lesson and this learner was really struggling with the maths equations that were being written on the board. But then we said to the student, "What are you into, mate? What's your thing? Why are you in this lesson? Why engineering?" And he looked at us. He said, "I love cars. I love motors. I love the Dodge 2015. That's my car." So then we said to Gemini, "Right, Gemini, relate that equation to the Dodge 2015 and explain it using metaphors and analogies." And it did. And used examples from the suspension, the chassis, the design. And I remember the look on that lad's face as we were going through it and explaining the equation. And that was a glimmer of what might be. And I can't wait to be doing that more with students. And the power of generative AI to personalize learning, if it's scaffolded and guided with guardrails from educators, yeah, that's something. The idea of there being three functional skills, English, maths and digital, is at the heart of our strategy here at the college. We have to prepare people for what's needed in industry. We prepare people for jobs. We know that along with English and math skills, digital is that functional skill that we have a duty to develop and grow in all learners. So for example, our automotive and motorsport students are creating vlogs of themselves carrying out car services and adding in images that are annotated with their process and their iterations and their evaluative thoughts as they problem solve. It's fundamental to their future that they have this firm foundation and this skill set, and more to the point, how to use these tools correctly, not just tokenistically, but intentionally, to help them use these tools in a way that enhances their chances in life and makes them employable. I really like collaborating with people, and I always find that if I do anything good, it's because I've seen it on social media or through networks that I've been lucky enough to build over the last 15 years of my career. And I find that by sharing in a Google chat group or whether it be on a Google Meet every month or two, just to share what we're up to, is enormously beneficial. I think we need to be less tribal in education. I never understood that as to why people are so particular about what they're doing. I'm quite open. I don't really feel precious about anything we do. I think we need to be, I suppose, less egocentric when it comes to coming up with new ideas and embrace the fact that other people are doing really cool things. And if we just take and mix and refresh different things in our context, we can do interesting things. One of the byproducts of the rise of generative AI is this need to rethink assessment. It's difficult to plagiarize when you're being on the spot, as it were, and talking in a viva or a witness statement with your professor, talking about these things and justifying and backing it up with evidence. So we're seeing this rise of more authentic, engaging, original assessment, which is actually opening up doors of possibility for those non-traditional learners who have been restricted through their school career being only the essay as their gateway to showing they are good enough, or only the exam being the way that they are good enough. And that fills my heart. Whether it be originality and helping people to think in new and creative ways to put together and construct evidence in a way that goes beyond the essay, a website or a blog or an iterative project, or whether it be responsibility in giving them project-based learning based in our community, where they're responsible for raising funds or having real skin in the game in developing projects using technology to help them do so. So I am excited about the rise of authentic assessment. Thank you for watching. I'm Scott Hayden, and this is Teaching for Tomorrow.